Welcome. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you. In the name of Jesus, the will of the Father, and the prayer of the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And friends have been here today. So what's going to happen at the beginning, we just want to let you know because it's a little different. Deacon wanted to, this is kind of an anniversary month for all of us who were ordained. And this is Deacon Gill's 10th, and that happens to be my 40th right this month. So we are going to reenact something that we that all ordained people do at the ordination day, which is lay prostrate on the ground. You lay yourself up completely as a sign of total giving of yourself to the Lord. That you're completely in God's hands. And if you're helpless, you're in God's hands to be used. So as we come down the aisle just after our ministers come forward, we will lay out our, at least those of us who can get down and get back up again. The reason why you're ordained when you're young, because you can get back up again after you get down. So we'll prostrate ourselves as a sign of our recommitment to the Lord, and we'll continue on with our celebration. It's great to have the St. Benedict's Youth Choir with us today.
Father, Son, and Spirit, all moving in
and existing in love, and calling us ever deeper into our own personal relationship with God. This Mass is being said for Julia Bailey. Before we start our Mass, we remind you to please turn off any cell phones, pagers, and beepers so as not to disrupt our morning Mass. Please stand now and join our celebrant, Father Bob, as well as our deacon and all of our honored guests as they come forward to the altar.
The interest hymn is, He is a Great God.
Here today, and friends, I'm happy to introduce who's here with us today.
We have Deacon Wallace. Deacon Wallace is the deacon here. It's an inside joke. This is Deacon Pouncey. And just want you to know, in the back on the table, the New World, on the front page, there's a big picture of this guy, so he can sign it for you after Mass.
But when Ponzi charges for autographs, so I wouldn't.
Then I have my, today.
Then I have my mentor here, Deacon Leonard Richardson from Saint Dorothy. My brother in the struggle.
Always.
Always. This is Deacon Pablo Perez. He does prison ministry.
Yes.
Amen, amen. What a good day to be in the house of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
This is the day the Lord has made. What does it say?
Let us rejoice and be glad.
What a beautiful, beautiful day today, and what a great celebration we have today. Today we have a celebration of, not of a feast, but of a doctrine, of a belief, which actually is the most basic belief we Christians should. There is no more belief more important than what we stand for today, the belief in the Trinity. Right? Amen?
Yeah.
There's one God, that are so awesome, so mysterious, so marvelous, that one can't contain him. It has to be three. Three faces, as I like to call it. Three faces of God. The face of love and mercy, the face of freedom and salvation, and the freedom of passion, the spirit of energy. So we celebrate that today on this beautiful day. Let us begin and give God all the glory with the first line we ever learned, which honors the Trinity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Amen. As we gather today, let us just ponder the depth and the height and the length of this God that we serve. What an awesome God we serve.
Amen.
What a mighty God. Every word we say is narrow and limited. As preachers, we preach our heart out, but we don't even come close to touching the goodness of God. Let's just bow our heads for a moment and reflect on the Trinity in your life. Do we take time for the Father and the Son and the Spirit?
Lord Jesus, Father, you loved us that we might love others. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, Son, the Father sent you that we all might be saved and have everlasting life. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, Holy Spirit, you came that we might have power and life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us. May God forgive us for all of our sin, and may God bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. When you have a God as great as this, you just got to sing and shout out our praise. Let's join our great choir in praising the name of our awesome God.
To God in the highest, and on earth peace to
friends, let us pray. God, our marvelous, marvelous Abba, Father, Yahweh, by sending into this world Jesus, the Logos, the Word of Truth, the Holy Spirit of power, you made known to the human race a wonderful mystery. Grant, Lord, we pray that today as we profess the true faith, may acknowledge this Trinity, a powerful glory and majesty, and also adore your unity, your glory, and your kingship. We ask all our prayers with the name of Jesus Christ our Lord, in the unity of the Spirit, all as one God, forever and ever. And let the church say,
Amen.
Amen. Please be seated now. And as always, let's jump into our first part of our service and turn to the Word of God. The three powerful readings about the Father, the Son, and the Spirit.
A reading from the book of the Proverbs, chapter 8:32-31. Thus says the wisdom of God, the Lord possess me, beginnings of his ways, the forerunner of his prodigies of long ago. From of old I was poured forth, at first before the earth. When there were no depths, I brought forth. When there were no mountains or fountains or springs of water, before the mountains were settled into place, before the hills, I was brought forth. While as yet the earth and the fields were not made, nor the first clods of the world. When the Lord established the heavens, I was there. When he marked out the vault over the face of the deep, when he made firm the skies above, when he fixed fast the foundations of the earth, when he set for the sea its limit, so that the waters should not transgress his command. Then was I beside him as his craftsman, and I was his delight day by day, playing before him all the while, playing on the surface of his earth, and I found delight in the human race. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. chapter 5, verses 1 through 5. Peace with God, your Lord Jesus Christ. Through him we have gained access by faith to his grace in which we stand, and we boast in hope of the glory of God. Not only that, we even boast of our afflictions, knowing that affliction produces endurance, and endurance proven character, and proven character hope. And hope does not disappoint, because the Lord of God has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Many different companies. One day his warehouse burnt to the ground. This led to many orders being canceled and a loss of customers. And to make matters worse, the insurance company was not going to cover the damage. The guy was in real trouble. He could lose everything. But the guy decided to see his minister. He said to the minister, "I need help. My warehouse burned to the ground. My product is all gone. My customers are leaving. And I'm losing everything." So the minister told him, "You can find all the answers to your problems in the Bible." The guy asked, "Where should I start?" The minister answers, "If you don't know where to start, just open a book and place your finger on the page and start right there. Sooner or later, you'll find your answer." Well, a few months later, the minister ran into the individual. And it was obvious the individual had become very successful. He had a new car, new clothes, several rings, chains. And the guy walked over to the minister and says, "Thank you. The answers I found turned my life around." The minister was curious and said, "What passage did you find the answer?" And the man says, "I did what you said. I opened the Bible to a spot. I looked down, and I found the answer staring me right in the face. Chapter 13. Put over your head for a minute, that did the church. Don't feel bad. The first mass did the same thing, amen. But see, church, children, I'll explain chapter 13 to you all later. But today, church, I'm here to tell you that I cannot give you a fresh start. I cannot grant you a chapter 13. But I plan to spend a minute preaching about a man who can give you a fresh start. I'm here to preach about a man that can give you a fresh start, a man who can give you a new life. And he can do it again and again and again. Do you know his name?
Yes.
Well, somebody say Jesus.
Jesus.
Somebody say Jesus again.
Jesus.
And one more time for the Holy Spirit.
Jesus.
Church, God is good.
All the time.
And all the time,
God is good.
Church, it is good to be in the house of the Lord one more time.
Yes.
You know, I love being in church. I love being around Christians. And I love preaching about Jesus. You know, God has been good to me. Now, I can't speak for you all, but I know God has been good to me because I look out and see all my children. I love them so much. And people I work with, St. Benedict, Holy Angels, and deacons and friends I grew up with, it is just a blessing. So we all have to just give Jesus a round of applause because he's worthy to be praised. Say thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
When you go to bed at night, you should say thank you, Jesus. And right now, if somebody is going through something today that's gotten them a little discouraged, worried, distracted, or distressed, or disturbed, today, give it to the Lord.
Amen.
We're going to take it to the altar and give it to the Lord. We're going to give it to the Lord, to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, to a God who is able to turn your pain into gain, a God who is able to turn your doubt into faith, a God who is able to turn your trial into triumph, and Timothy, a God who is able to turn your mess into a holy message. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
You see, church, I believe God is placing you today at this time for a holy reason. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit has a word for someone today. And if you're ready to receive a word, just say amen.
Amen.
On this most Holy Trinity Sunday, I'd like to preach from the topic, a copper kettle Christian. A copper kettle Christian. But today is a special day, and it's good to see my brother Deacons here, because 10 years ago, Francis George, who I affectionately call my friend, he gave me this book of the Gospels. inside the book, there's an inscription. And the inscription reads, "Receive this book of the gospel, whose herald you now are." Come on, deacons. Believe what you read, and teach what you believe, and practice what you teach. In other words, the cardinal ordained us and said, you better practice what you preach. And on ordination day, 10 years ago, we lay prostrate on the cold cathedral floor, scared, uncertain, doubtful, worried. For myself, that I may not be able to live up to those words. Those are some powerful words. They may sound easy, but they're powerful. Believe what you read, and teach what you believe. And I am a firm believer that if you are going to walk the walk, you must talk the talk.
Amen.
You see, you cannot be a fraud, amen.
Amen.
You cannot be a pretender. You cannot be a deceiver, and you can't be a liar.
Amen.
First Timothy says, if you are going to be a church leader, you must take care of the church of God.
Amen.
And be mature. This ain't kids' business.
All right.
You must be mature in faith so that you will not swell up with pride and be condemned as the devil was. Talking the talk is a lot easier than walking the walk.
Yes, it is.
It's not an easy task when you have to be a light to the world as an image of Christ. People need to see someone and feel that they are witnessing the gospel of Jesus Christ, not their own gospel. And that gospel that they preach sometimes is by their behavior. It's by their life and behavior. And brothers and sisters of Christ, as we look out, it is very dark out there, amen? It is very dark out there. And there is a light that needs to shine. For this person or these people are always not available, or they're not visible. And it's dark out there. Sometimes they're stuck inside when they're able to be outside, or busy doing church business and missing doing God's business. Pope Francis had a quote where he put it into perspective. He says, I see the church as a field hospital after battle. Now, it is useless to ask a seriously injured person if he has high cholesterol. Or about the level of his blood sugar, amen?
Amen?
You have to heal his wounds. Then you can talk about everything else. So see, that's what we're called to do. See, we can go out and save a soul. But before you want to preach doctrine, are you with me, church?
Amen.
Before you preach doctrine, save the soul. That's what this calling is about. This calling is about saving souls. I recently read a story about a woman involved in a weekly Bible study who made a significant discovery quite accidentally in her basement. One day she noticed that some potatoes had sprouted in the darkest corner of the room. At first she could not figure out how they received the light to grow. Then she noticed that she hung a copper kettle from the rafter near the cellar window. See, this woman, she the kettle every day. And the kettle was so brightly polished that it reflected the rays of the sun onto the potatoes. She explained privately, when I saw that reflection, I thought, I may not be a preacher or a teacher with the ability to expound upon scriptures, but at least I can be a copper kettle Christian. I can catch the rays of the sun of God, and through the Holy Spirit, I can reflect His light to someone in a different corner of the life. Amen. See, brothers and sisters of Christ, we can be that copper kettle Christian shooting the rays of the sun out to the people. See, the copper kettle was used to bring the sun into an otherwise dark potato. The copper kettle was used to bring the sun into a dark space. The Capocella was a vessel used to bring the sunlight of Christ to something that caused it to grow. Amen, children? The Capocella is surely a reflection of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. You see, church, sometimes when we feel scared or uncertain, doubtful, or worried, we need to turn on that light. You need to turn on that light of Christ that lies within each and every one of us. This is not an exclusive light given to the priest and to the deacon. This is a light that's given to each and every one of us who believe. Yeah. See, the light is there, but it's like the kettle. Amen. Sometimes it's got to be rubbed and massaged and nurtured so that it can shine. You know, sometimes if you set an old kettle down, it'll get all, what's the word, varnishy?
Tarnish.
I'm just checking. See, church, we need more copper kettle Christians.
Amen.
To light up this dark world which we live in today. We need more copper kettle Christians that are anointed and full of the Holy Spirit on fire for Jesus. We need more copper kettle Christians preaching the word of God with boldness, bringing souls to Christ, encouraging one another, building each other up, lifting them up instead of knocking them down. We need more copper kettle Christians to bring unity into the community. Amen. This is Trinity Sunday. Amen. It's all about unity. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit become one. But you have to become one in order to make a difference. So if we want to change the look, the landscape of the community, we have to have unity. And for Christians, the Trinity is the primary symbol of a community. That's what holds the community together, the unity. And my brothers and sisters in Christ, I'm here today to tell you that if we're going to build up the human community, that's where the copper kettle Christian has to shine brightest.
Amen.
Building up the community. Let's all like to belong. We like to belong to a family, to a church, to a community. No man is an island. We all need the love, support, and friendship of others in our family and in our community. Not only do we like to belong, we need to belong. Because it's not good to be alone. Every single person has a desire to belong to a community of love. And I guarantee you something, church, about bringing unity in the community. Any, and I see some couples out here that know where I'm getting ready to go. Any happy family, any happy church, and any happy school, and any happy community is headed by a copper kettle. Amen?
Amen?
That's right. There's somebody that's leading, that's in charge, that's shining the light of Christ, teaching the values, teaching what's right and what's wrong. That's what's missing in our community today, church. We need more copper kettle Christians. See, a copper kettle Christian is not afraid to act or to live by the authority of the Word of God and to follow the Holy Spirit. And the greatest danger, church, facing the church today is the attack on the authority of the Word of God. There has become a gentle coldness and indifference to biblical truth and God's standards of righteousness. You see, church, we want to live like we want to live. We want to act like we want to act. We want to do what we want to do. The problem is, who are we minding? And because of our own agendas, somebody say agendas.
Agendas.
We have brought in attitudes. Y'all, we know about attitudes, amen?
Amen.
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 Amen, children.
Amen.
We know we have brought in attitudes and our own agendas that are affecting the community. And because of that, we're witnessing a trickle-down effect. We're witnessing the destruction of our communities. We're witnessing the destruction of our families. We're witnessing the destruction of our country. We're witnessing the destruction of our world, and we are witnessing the destruction of our church. So, brothers and sisters in Christ, we need to take the gospel to the community. It's time to take the gospel to the community. You know, we watched the movie Friday Risen, and all those, the movies about the resurrection and the post-resurrection, but you know, if we read the book of Acts and we get a closer look at what these guys did after Jesus left, those are the models of a copper-kettle Christian. They were anointed and full of the Holy Spirit. They were preaching the word of God with boldness. Miracles, signs, and wonders was happening all over the town. Thousands were being saved and added to the numbers. People gave in their possessions for the cause of Christ. They were so united that they were filled with the Holy Spirit that they turned the world upside down. That was then and this is now. But the interesting thing about that was then and this is now, it's the same God. Amen. Jesus was the same yesterday, he's the same today, and he's going to be the same tomorrow. So what's the problem? We serve a mighty God. You know, and Jesus, you know, they saw Jesus. They were with Jesus. Okay, I give them that. But John 20 says, do you believe because you see me? But happy are those who believe without seeing me.
Amen.
So he knew we was gonna use that as an excuse. Brothers and sisters in Christ, we want unity and community. Church has to come on one accord. Where there is a church in unity, where there is a church in one accord, where there is a church that stands united in faith, many will be saved. And as we go out and see people, whether they're white, black, whatever, they're people, and they all should be looked at as a candidate for the gospel.
Amen.
Yeah. Even people you may not like, it's a candidate for the gospel, amen?
Amen.
And maybe you might need a little gospel too, that's why you may not like him. I'm just saying. You know, I said the politicians need Christ.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And you know, our God is a powerful God. He's strong enough to save them, folks.
Yeah.
He can save them too. He wants us. He wants us out there. Going to his people. Spread his word, church. That's what it's all about. Spreading his word. The gospel is what we live by. And I can't say it enough, at least for me and my ministry. I try my best to be a light of Christ in the community. You know, that's otherwise lying on that floor, accepting that book of the Gospels, it doesn't mean nothing if you don't live it.
Amen.
And that's where sometimes I get upset with priests, deacons. We all took the same book, we all laid on the same floor, but yet, you know, the community is dying. 1,200 shootings this year so far. 240-something kids or people killed. 20 expressway shootings. 13-year-old kid stabbed a 15-year-old kid, and the mama gave it a knife. You know, one parent kills her daughter because she thinks she's sick. Lady gets shot because she stopped at Starbucks to get a cup of coffee. See, this killing and all this is going on in our community because there is no unity in the community, church. For me right now to see all these children here who came, it means so much because this is what it's all about. This is my roses before my, you know where I'm going with that. These are my flowers, amen, I believe in that. These are my flowers. Right now, these are my flowers. No matter what, I can look out here at these kids and they smiling and they happy because they got a copper kettle Christian leading them, amen. So my brothers and sisters in Christ, I'm just here today to say God is good and all the time, but we all have to carry that message out because this world, you need it. What does 2 Chronicles say? If my people will call by my name, will seek my face, humble themselves, pray, and I will hear. I'll hear their voices from heaven, and I will what? I will heal their land. So scripture don't lie. God says, pray, I will heal. So brothers and sisters Christ, we're called to be these copper kettle Christians today so that we can spread this light of Christ to this dark world. God bless, church. Thank you.
young people.
Give another round of applause.
Now let's all stand up now. As young people, we're singing, and we just need to keep our young people in our prayers, church. Amen. And all of us of our generation know you can walk down the store and get a piece of candy without being shot. Today you can't even do that. Let's pray for these young people that they may stay safe today. And there's evil in this world, church. Amen. There's evil. That's what causes this garbage that's going on. But we got to pray for the bigger power.
Amen.
You know what the bigger power is, don't you?
Amen.
It's our mighty God.
Amen.
Let's turn to our God now in prayer on this feast of Trinity. Power and our word.
Our response today is, Holy Trinity, hear our prayer.
Holy Trinity, hear our prayer.
For all of the Christian churches, that we may be one in relational unity, witnessing to the transforming love of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we pray to the Lord.
Holy Trinity, hear our prayers.
That love, toleration, and an end of terrorism and violence may grow among people of all nations and religions, through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us, we pray to the Lord.
Holy Trinity, hear our prayers.
For all of those suffering from AIDS, cancer, or other incurable diseases, that they may receive consolation from the God who cares for them, we pray to the Lord.
Holy Trinity, hear our prayers.
For a greater and renewed dedication for all of our community to take a stand against the violence in our community, and for all those victims of that violence, we pray to the Lord.
Holy Trinity, hear our prayers.
That all of us may grow in the Father's anchoring love and life, the Son's mercy and freedom, power and peace. We pray to the Lord.
Holy Trinity, hear our prayers.
For all of those in our nation's military service, especially those who have paid the ultimate price of their lives for our country and its freedoms, that they may share the glory of the true God, we pray to the Lord.
Holy Trinity, hear our prayers.
For all of our own very personal intentions, we pause to pray a moment in silence. We pray to the Lord.
Holy Trinity, hear our prayers.
Precious Lord, what a mighty, mighty God we serve. We cannot comprehend, Lord, you are higher, you are wider, you are deeper, you are broader, you are vaster than anything we could conceive, Lord. So we come before you and just pray for your anointing on our world and on ourselves, that we may radiate, as the deacon said today, radiate the sunshine and light of the Lord in the dark corners of our world today. We stand before you asking for blessing, power, confidence, courage, and peace. All in the name and under the power of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Let the church say,
Amen.
Amen. Please be seated now.
The Bible tells us to be with the gifts we are stewards of, for God loves a cheerful giver. Before bringing up our bread and wine, we ask you to bring your monetary gift to God. Please come to the front of church to place your gift in our offering basket. Our second collection is for our Dump the Debts. Your ongoing support has been greatly appreciated.
Thank you. These gifts of our service. By them, make us, Lord, an eternal offering to you. We ask all our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And friends, the Lord is with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. It is our duty. It is our salvation every moment of life to honor and praise that beautiful name of our mighty God. Lord, with your only begotten Son, Jesus, with the Spirit of God, you are one God, one Lord, not in the unity of a single person, but in the threeness of one substance. Because what you have revealed to us of your glory, we also believe is that of the Son and of the Spirit. So that as we confess today one true God, you might be adored in what is proper to each person. A unity in their substance, but in quality, in glory and majesty. So, Lord, this too is praised by the angels. It is praised by the archangels in heaven. It is praised by our ancestors who've gone before us. Let's lift our voices now and sing with them a hymn of praise to our mighty God. Being who we give our life to, our Lord God, as we sit in quiet awe now of His presence at our altar. We use prayer number 3 today. Lord, you are indeed holy. Everything you have created rightfully gives you praise, for through your Son, Jesus, by the power of the Spirit, you give life to everything and you make it holy. You never cease gathering people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a perfect sacrifice may be made in your name. Therefore, Lord, we your people humbly ask you, by that same Holy Spirit, make holy these gifts. You bring them for consecration. May they become for us the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus. At his command, we celebrate this mystery. Now, on the night that our Lord Jesus Christ was betrayed and suffered, died eventually for us. At that night, Jesus took bread off a table, thanked you, Father, said the blessing, broke that bread, handed it to his family, his friends, to us, and he said, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a very similar way, when that final meal of his life was ended, Jesus took a cup of wine, thanked his Father, handed it to all of us, his friends, and he said, take this, all of you, drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and the eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. And then he said, do this, memory of me.
The mystery of faith. Celebrate this memorial
of the saving passion of your Son, of his wonderful resurrection and ascension, as we look forward to his coming back to this world again, we offer you in thanks this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon this offering of our church, recognizing the sacrificial victim by his death you chose to reconcile us, Lord. Grant that we today, who are fed, who are nourished with this food of Jesus at this table, that we may be filled with that sweet, sweet spirit and become one in Jesus. And may he make of us an eternal offering to you, that, Lord, we might obtain an inheritance with all the elect, especially with our mother, Mother Mary, with all of our great saints, the apostles, our ancestors, our relatives, and whose constant intercession in your presence we are relying for help. Lord, we pray today that this sacrifice of reconciliation, peace, may advance peace and salvation in this world, and especially, once again, we pray that also may bring an end to this terrorism, an end to this violence that continues to plague our streets. Lord, please especially be pleased to confirm in faith and love our pilgrim church. Bless our leaders, Pope Francis, Bishop Blaise, Bishop Perry, all your clergy, all the people that you've gained for your own. Father, listen to the prayers of everyone in this church right now. You have summoned us here this morning. In your great compassion, in your great love, Father, gathered yourself children from all over the world who are scattered and do not know you. Finally, to everyone who has departed, to our departed ancestors, brothers, sisters, relatives, friends, to everyone who's pleasing to you at their passing from this life, Lord, give kind admittance to your kingdom. Because someday, Lord, we hope to see them again. We hope to enjoy with them again the fullness of your glory with Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on this world everything that through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. To pray this greatest of prayers. It's often occurred to me, I wonder what Jesus must have thought when his buddies, his friends said, teach us how to pray. I mean, how do you describe your own Father, huh? How do you teach somebody to pray to Allah, to Yahweh? Thank God for these beautiful words which capture it all, this essence of the threeness, the three faces of our one God. Let us sing together.
Thank you.
apostles, the same words, same message that echoes down to us today, which we still have not learned. Peace. Peace. My peace I give to you. A peace this world cannot give because it doesn't have it. Do not look upon our fears, our sin, our worry, our shame, our guilt. Look on the faith and the hope we have in you. Give us the healing and the hope of your kingdom. For you live and you reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace, the joy of Jesus be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Now, my brothers and sisters, let us turn toward one another and offer a sign of Christ's peace.
Let us kneel now before us. Lord, when we receive Jesus, we also receive the Father and the Spirit. Because in one sense, you can never separate Jesus from the Spirit of the Father. So as you come to receive the Lord today, you literally see the Lord, the Father's love, the presence of Jesus, the anointing of Spirit. With joy in our hearts, we praise God as we say, Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn.
I
know, this is not what we see on the news. And you don't see children praising God on the news. We see all the negativity in our neighborhoods and our communities. We get to miss out on all the beauty of our children. It is a wonderful blessing to have two young ladies, I know since they were little bitty girls, praising God the way they do.
Amen.
That's part of bringing the gospel to the community.
Yes.
And creating this unity in the community. You know, as long as we raise our children up right, there is hope. Amen.
Amen.
There is light at the end of the tunnel.
Yes.
Amen.
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 I have to say, those dancers were, their energy was just so radiant. So thank you for that. Applause for our guest children's choir. They were awesome. Thank you to all of you. You've really blessed us today with your gifts. We do have a few announcements today. As our busy May and June rolls on, please remember to plan on attending our annual block party on Saturday, June 25th. It's our 10th anniversary, I can't believe it, and special t-shirts in the Jubilee colors of burgundy and bling are available. So please see the sample on the back bulletin board and use a handout to order one. We have several special Jubilee announcements for this week. First off, we have confirmed that we will only order one bus for the June 19th. If you have already signed up, there's no need to sign up again, but we do need you to confirm that you will ride the bus by initializing the list again. So we need you to put your initials next to your name. We have only 50 seats on the bus, and it's a free bus, so you don't want to miss out. Please initial your name. Secondly, tickets for the 1 o'clock p.m. banquet on June 19th are going very, very fast. Praise God. However, if you have not yet paid for either a table or your seat, nothing can be guaranteed as the banquet rapidly fills up. So we strongly encourage you to get your seat right now, preferably today. We will not be able to promise several seats next to each other much longer. So please talk to a ticket representative after Mass today or call Pauline Miller at the rectory. We have a couple of meetings. Wednesday through Friday, there is morning Mass at 7 o'clock in the morning in the rectory. And then on Thursday, Bible study at 9 o'clock in the morning as usual. And the block party committee will meet at noon for a lunch meeting to finalize plans for our June 25th event. Finally, please do not stop bringing non-perishable food items for the St. Column Famous Food Pantry because we continue to help them out. Now, I know there are many, many visitors with us today because I see all of your beautiful faces. So if you would please stand. Oh, okay.
I'll just kind of simplify it.
Sounds good.
I'm very blessed to have many, many visitors here today. First of all, thank you to my children from St. Benedict,
yes,
choir.
Amen.
The teachers and staff from St. Benedict are here as well. The principal of St. Benedict is here. The principal from St. Narrator, where I work with their kids on second Sundays of the month. She's here, back there. My Holy Angel family is here. Where I was for 30 years. And then all my friends, deacons, and their wives, and guy I grew up with from 40, for a few years. This guy over here, we've been friends probably 50 years. And then my plumbers are here, so family. I say Dorothy's family, of course, amen. Amen. Yeah, yeah. Even got a videographer, check that out, you check that out. Mr. Callaway from Holy Angels. And my girls. Kurt got it, look, as soon as I said my girls. Courtney and Kirsten. Of course, my immediate family's here, my mom and kids, and I think about 7 or 8 grandkids.
All right.
Amen. Thank you.
Welcome. Are there any birthdays or anniversaries this week? If so, please stand and let us know how old you are. I see one over here.
Today's my birthday. I'm 9 years old.
Today?
9 years old. May 23rd. You're 2 years older than 9, I'm presuming. Congratulations. What's that?
59.
59. All right. Congratulations.
Friday, it will be my golden birthday, and I'll be turning 27 years old.
All right, Elias. Great job, ladies. Who are you?
Bianca.
10 years old?
Yes.
Congratulations, Bianca. Happy birthday. Yes, my good friend Iris.
23rd Wednesday,
25th
Wednesday,
I'll be 66. Congratulations, Iris. Teresa.
I have my grandson who will be celebrating just 8th birthday.
I didn't see my sister-in-law over there. She just had a birthday yesterday. Amen.
All right, happy birthday to you. Blessing.
Today I graduate.
Today you graduate. Did I miss anybody else? Oh, there you are. I can't see you. Phyllis McCain. How can I miss Phyllis Winston? Tuesday, another May birthday. Great month for birthdays. Happy birthday. Charlene. All right, Charlene, May 29th. All right, Charlene. All right.
Thank you for praying with us and having a great meeting.
Just briefly, after Mass, please come over to the gym. We have refreshments. Good stuff for you guys. So come on over to the gym for refreshments and fellowship.
A couple more things we want to announce to our good friend Joseph Konya. Is here today with his great things from the motherland, and stop by and see Joseph on your way out today. We do want to give a shout out to, we had a confirmation this week in the deanery, and we had 6 of our young people who were confirmed. Do you hear? Stand up. Those of you who are confirmed. We are going to have, for especially for Saint Dorothy folk, Deacon Leroy was talking about the violence in the neighborhood. 2 weeks from now, on June 5th, we're going to be the hosting church for a 3:30 in the afternoon kind of an event called U.S.A, sponsored by the Prosperity Foundation. Chicago Police will be here. Alderman Sawyer will be here. Community organizations, city and state. We'll be talking more about that, but that'll be June the 5th, 3:30 in the afternoon. I believe our choir will be singing a song as well on June the 5th, too. Just a word before we close this out today. It has been a joy. I've known Leroy myself personally. Everybody knows I was at Holy Angels for 10 years.
before I wound up here at St. Dorothy's. And Deacon Leroy, I knew him back before he was even a deacon. When he was just simply a little old plumber doing his own shit. But I was privileged to be a lot of part of Deacon's story through a lot of ups and through a few downs. But we had a lot of tremendous things happen in Deacon's life. And having him here at St. Dorothy's was a real coup for us to be able to have Deacon Leroy here with us. So I want you, when you go out, he drives a black pickup truck. And on the back of it, it says Gilco, right? On the back of his bumper, it says, he has a bumper sticker. It says, honor thy plumber. Am I right?
On my new truck, on my other truck.
On your other truck. Oh, he's got a brand new fancy truck. Talk about chapter 13. One of your trucks, he's got his bumper sticker, honor thy plumber. And I thought there's great significance in that because he is a plumber by profession, has his own company. But you know, you can look at it in a spiritual sense, God's world leaks bad. And Leroy is one of those people who fixes the leaks in God's world. What we like to do here is we like to have a special blessing for people. So I'm going to call Leroy and Teresa, because we all know as great as Leroy is, his wife Teresa is just as fantastic. We have two very special friends of mine who are here today, and I want them to come on up and help me. I've had the deacons come on up here too. Two special friends of mine who are here today. I want to come up and give a blessing. Father Paul Whittington, come on up, Paul. And my very, very good friend, John Calicott. John, come on up. John Calicott. I want to pray a blessing upon Leroy. I'm going to ask Father Paul. Dominicans have all the great words, right, Paul? So, Dexter, come on out. My good friend, Deacon Dexter Watson. Come on down here, Deacon. There's a lot of great people in the house here today, so you guys stand up in front here. There you go.
Yes, sir. This is my boss here. This deacon here, boy. Yes, sir.
Yes, we pray. Let's hold it.
Stretch out our hands.
Let's all say a prayer. Stretch out our hands as Father Paul leads us in a prayer.
Loving and precious God, we come this day to give you thanks, to give you honor, to give you glory. We call now for a special blessing upon Deacon Gill and Teresa. We ask you to anoint their lives, to touch them from the soles of their feet to the top of their head, so that they might worthily give you the praise, the honor, and glory to the very goodness of their lives.
Yes.
We thank you for their 10 years of service to your church, but even longer for the service that they've given.
Yes.
For the ways in which they've touched people's lives as they've walked this journey of faith. We ask you now to continue to guide and to bless them, so that they may continue to be beacons of hope to all whom they serve, to all whose lives they touch. Bless the many children whom they minister to and with. Bless the many people whom they serve in their respective ministries and their respective jobs. We ask you, Lord God, to guide them that they might always be able to be people of hope, people of faith, people of joy, people of love, who share those gifts with others. Lord, we now live in a hurting world, a world that is torn apart by violence, by war, by all kinds of issues and problems. But we pray that they may be people who bring about light in the midst of darkness, people who bring about joy where there's so much. People are living in despair. Touch their hearts, touch their families so that they will continue to serve you until they are no longer able to serve.
Yes.
And then, Lord, when they can't serve anymore, we pray that you might serve them in gratitude for the many ways in which they've served us.
Yes.
And so now, Lord, as we come to the close of the service, continue to anoint these special people for whom we ask this prayer in the mighty name of Jesus, and let the church say,
Amen.
just follow the crowd. And gun on over and have a great bike seat over there too. Let's all stand up now. Let's go out with a blessing. My friends, may the Lord be with you. I pray the Spirit on you, the three faces of God to shine on you this way. The face of the mercy and the love of our God, our Father. The power, the freedom of Jesus Christ who set us free, and the energy and the passion of the Spirit of God. May God's faces be with you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
When are you guys going to get us out of here?
Well, yeah. I'm thinking of the gospel.
Wallace is wandering.
The mass is ended. Let us go forth and live.
Come on, get over
about
here.
The gospel. And thanks be to God.
Well,
they don't know that, so no. I ain't going.
All right, the master's ready to go in peace and be and preach to God. I had to say hello to the deacon's wives. See, the deacon's wives don't always get recognized. And so they're sitting in the first and second pew there, and so the deacons can't be deacons without their wives.
Amen.
And so I had to say hello to the wives.
Amen.
Let's draw this song, shall we?
Please join in singing our recessional Every Praise.
All right. All right. All right. All right.
See you next week.